Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Early this year, I made a video about creating an interactive web UI for CrewAI applications. And in that video, I implemented a simple web server to visualize the CrewAI agents and workflows and allow users to interact with messages. Since then, CrewAI has undergone many changes and improvements from version 0.28 to 0.80. Not only the API usage has been changed a lot, but also the entire architecture is different after this half of the year. There are many developers in the tech community told me that the previous video is outdated and they cannot update the CrewAI for new features but retain the existing UI designs in their projects. In this video, I will show you how to create the same web UI for the latest version of CrewAI framework. You can see the innovative procedure for quickly building a multi-agent application with the new architecture, the way to customize the app by redirecting the agent's default output to the chat UI of panel, which is a Python library for building custom web apps, and how to interact with those agents by sending messages on the UI. If you follow my last implementation, you must spend some time to refresh yourself to look at what significant changes has been made to the development of this CrewAI framework. During the May and June, the CrewAI added various features like setting a manager for crews, customized prompt and response template. It also introduced the new agent type to execute code directly, interaction with third-party agents from various platforms, integration with external tools, and a training CLI, which significantly increased the framework's capability in handling complex and dynamic tasks. Those are all helpful features, and I will demonstrate how to leverage and expand them in future videos. To me, the most innovative step forward of CrewAI is its ability to create a complete application with a single command. With just CrewAI create crew and your crew name, you can instantly generate a fully functional multi-agent application with all the necessary modules, documents, configuration files. This includes pre-configured agents, roles, and tasks in YAML files, and a crew orchestration module, and the environment variables template. The generated project structure follows the best practice and includes features like task callbacks, processing management, and agent coordination out of the box. So let's warm up with an example of a CrewAI project. First, install the latest version of CrewAI, which is the current version of 0.80. Next, create a new CrewAI project using its command, CrewAI create crew, let's say research crew. During the creation, you will be asked to choose language model provider. Let's choose OpenAI. Choose one for OpenAI. Here for the exact model you want to use, let's choose 3 for GPT-40 mini. And now you are required to import your OpenAI API key. After a couple of seconds, you will see a message showing that your crew has been successfully created. And there will be a new directory called research crew in your current working folder, with the basic structure of your entire project. In the structure, you will find the source folder. There will be a main.py and a crew.py. with two YAML files that located in the config directory, agents, and tasks. So when you open this source code, you will find that the new structure separates the coding sections from the configuration sections, which allows more collaboration between agent and prompt and tool designers who is not coders, and the multi-agent capabilities and workflows that are required to be changed by the coding developers. When you see this default project, you'll find that it demonstrates a simple multi-agent workflow that researches and reports on the latest AI developers for a given topic. So let's run the app by running its building command. Let's move to the folder and run CrewAI run. Okay, you see the final result has been generated. The first agent called AILLM, Senior Data Researcher, who provides 10 bullet points highlighting the most relevant and interesting information about AILLMs in 2024. So the topic is defined in the main file, defined in the imports with the topic AILLMs. This is the final result of the first task with the first agent. The second task is from the reporting agents who give a final report based on the 10 points that generated by the research agent. Understand that now, let's move to the main topic of this video to see how to wrap this command line application into the panel web UI based on the source code structure. So following our design purpose, let's redirect the task's output and the human input into the chat UI of panel. So let's install the panel first. And then moving to the CrewPy, which is located in the source directory. Here you need to create the chat interface object from panel's widget library. So let's import the panel and then create the chat interface as a global variable. We need to define the print output function to send the task's output to the panel's chat UI. So in this callback, we just print the output's raw content and feed it to the chat interface send function to send it to the front end. This function is designed to be called when a task is complete. So we need to register it as a callback function to each task definition. Let's find the task decorator and add callback parameter as print output, and also the next task with the same callback. In this case, we are allowed the report agent to interact with the user as a final step of the workflow to have a further instructions from user. So we need to put human input argument as true to allow this operation. That's all for this crew.py file. Let's move to the main file. So in this file, we need to first remove all the existing code because we have to run the app by using panel serve command instead of CrewAI run command in order to wrap the crew workflow in web. So the existing general execution is no longer needed. So first, we need to manually import the OpenAI API key from the .env file, which is initialized when we run the CrewAI command. Okay, now we need to define the callback function to handle the user input and feed it to the crew workflow and send the result back to the chat UI. So let's see the code. We import the research crew object and chat interface variable from the crew module directly, and we define the user input variable to record the user input message and use the crew started signal to represent the status of processing of the workflow. So in the callback function, we need to check if the Crew's workflow has been started. If not, we create a new thread to run the initiate chat function to deliver the user's query as a topic to start the workflow. Here we just simply kick off the crew by calling the crew constructor and with the kickoff method, which is imported from our modified crewai.py file. The reason why we use the thread here is that the kickoff method will block the panel's UI updating process, including further user imports and callbacks. So we need to run it in a separate thread to avoid blocking. And then if the crew's workflow has already been started, we can assume that the user's import now is just a feedback message for ongoing workflow. And then we can update the user import with the content of this message string, register the callback function to the chat interface object. Until now, the message output of the tasks has been implemented. It's time to process user input for the ongoing workflow. In the CrewAI framework, there's no explicit API for redirecting the user input from the command line to the chat UI. So we have to do a monkey patch to the crew agent executor mixing class to override the default AskHumanImport function with the custom AskHumanImport function. And in this function, we send the interim outputs called final answer from the calling of the crew agent executor back to the chat UI and plus a prompt message, please provide feedback on the final result and the agent's actions that ask users feedback and wait for users' input in a while loop. Once the message received, it returns the feedback message and the crew agent executor mixing class will continue to process with it. The logic design has been completed, and then we can add the code snippets for the panel server at the end of the code. So we first send the welcome message on the top of the UI and then run the servable method to make the entire chat interface servable. In this demo app, we will not modify the default definitions of agents or tasks because they are all domain-specific designs in your own project. So we only need to add one line in the task definition to notify the reporting agents to ask users feedback. We can add this sentence in the description here. Ask user input for more information if needed. So the code is complete. But before running the app, make sure you have run this command under the project folder, pip install. This command will install the crew module from the research crew we generated that importable from our internal project. Everything's ready. Now we can run the web app by executing the panel command, panel serve source research crew and man. After seeing this message, especially the app running at localhost 5006, which is the default port of panel app, then you can open your web browser and navigate to the URL to see the web app. So let's see that. Okay, here we see the welcome message, and then we can provide our desired topic, LLM. And you will see the first agent has already generated the list of the key points. And the second agent has generated an interim result of the report and asked the user to provide the feedback on this result. So let's ask it to add subtitle for each title. Okay, you see the report with subtitles has been finally generated by the reporting agent. So in conclusion, the whole idea of adding web UI to CrewAI is to reject the callback for output and find and replace the default human input function with the UI input function. As a popular open source project, CrewAI is still under active development and the architecture is expected to change further in the future, so I will keep looking at the latest version and update the video as needed. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.